think there is a fighting chance to live to 150 and not to extend old, miserable.
You cannot get lifespan without health span. They almost go hand to hand.
Would you say yes to living to 150? If so, is there anything you can do to make it happen? Let's use a bit of logic and common sense to find out and connect the dots. For now, let's say our goal is 150 to keep it as real and tangible as possible. What would have to happen for that? What are we missing today? Simple, but not easy. We miss enough anti-aging research and clinical trials. That's the only way me and you can get 250, right? We have to find the new drugs and understand how other non-aging species like naked mole rats, tortoises, immortal hydras function and then translate it to us humans. So, what do we need? What is the must-have for this anti-aging research to ramp up so we can see the results during our lifetime? We need scientists and we need money. Again, simple, just not very easy. And you might be thinking that not getting old and catching cancer, heart disease, dementia, the major diseases of aging is a big deal and the government is putting a lot of money towards the research, right? Wrong. Only 0.5% of National Institute of Health funding is devoted to the fundamental aging research. Unfortunately, today longevity is not popular at all. Maybe you think it is, but again, look at the numbers. However, that's hopefully something we can change, something we must change. Because it's almost like 100 years ago when we've just recently found that bacteria are causing infections with a lot of senseless deaths, but antibiotics, nah, who cares, we don't need them. Sounds stupid, right? So, how do we get money and how do we get new scientists to work on longevity? Simple, just not easy. We need government funding and donations to get the money going. And we need to create the interest in the aging research and science among the students. And so, here we come to the key. One thing, the critical component, which can push all these pieces forward at the same time. When Congressman's son calls his dad and asks, "Hey, what's getting done to double our lives?" When age reversal is discussed in the gym, at work, in the Daily Show, when we're going to see longevity billboards, signs on the buses, and people walking for curing aging. There is one and only one way we can make it happen. Through social influence and social networks. And guess what? You have the power to do that. And it is simple and, for a change, not hard. It's in your hands to share this video right away in any of the social networks of your choice. Facebook, Reddit, LinkedIn, you name it. Please do so and comment below to encourage more people to do the same. Because the more people will get the message, the sooner we get the critical mass to make the real progress. Now, what is this factor X on the picture? After you've shared this video and made this world a better place, it's important that you live long enough to see the results. Second layer of defense, if you will, solid 100 years old by design. Not by luck, by design. The best way to start on that path is to evaluate all your pillars of longevity, physical, mental, spiritual, locate the weakest links and start from improving them first and then repeating the process again and again to optimize. That's what's called the law of minimum. And I have a dedicated video where we will find your weakest link. Living is smart, aging is bad, and I'll see you there.